Good morning, students. In this video, I will start with your second UT syllabus of your English 2 syllabus. Your English 2 syllabus of your second UT is lesson number 6, Jawaharlal Nehru. Lesson 8, A Girl Called Manu. Poem, Nature is What We See. Novel, Mowgli. Lesson number 6, The End of Sher Khan. Lesson 7, Rescuing Missua. Today, I will complete lesson number 6, Jawaharlal Nehru. Everyone, open page number 54, lesson 6, Jawaharlal Nehru. I'm sure everybody of you is aware of Jawaharlal Nehru. So let's gain more knowledge about him from this lesson. Jawaharlal Nehru, or Chacha Nehru as children fondly, lovingly called him, was the first Prime Minister of independent India. He fought for India's independence and was imprisoned 9 times in this struggle. Struggle to free India from the Britishers. An imprisoned means kept in prison for 9 times. As Prime Minister, he developed India into a strong and peaceful nation. Jawaharlal Nehru loved children immensely, means very much, greatly. And his birthday, 14th November, is celebrated as Children's Day in India. So why is Children's Day celebrated on Jawaharlal Nehru's birthday? Because he used to love children very greatly, immensely. Jawaharlal Nehru was born on 14th November 1889 in Allahabad in British India. His mother was Swaroop Rani Tassu and his father was Motilal Nehru. Motilal Nehru was a very successful lawyer and also participated in the independence struggle. So students, what is the birthplace of Jawaharlal Nehru? Allahabad. When was he born? Born on 14th November 1889. What is his mother's name? Swaroop Rani Tassu. And father's name? Motilal Nehru. What was Motilal Nehru by occupation? He was a successful lawyer and he participated in independence struggle. For the first 16 years of his life, means till 16 years of age, Nehru was taught at home by tutors. Tutors is your private teacher at home. And English governesses. What is governesses? Means ladies who taught and took care of children in private houses. He later went to England and studied at Harrow School and Trinity College, Cambridge. Then Nehru went on to study law in London. He returned to India in 1912 and took a keen interest. Keen means a lot of interest in the independence struggle. In 1916, he married Kamala Kaul. A year later, their daughter Indira was born. She too would grow up to follow in her father's footsteps. Means daughter of Nehru. Who was daughter of Nehru? Indira Gandhi. He also followed his father's footsteps. Means also did the same thing what his father did. And one day become the Prime Minister of India. Now who became Prime Minister of India? One day Indira Gandhi. Now who is Indira Gandhi? Daughter of Jawaharlal Nehru. See, after his private teacher or private tuitions, he went to England and then went to London for his further studies. And then when he came back to India, he took great interest and participated in the independence struggle. Although Nehru was always connected with the political situation of his time. Political means whatever was going on in the state or in the government. He took keen interest and participated in all that. He wholeheartedly joined the freedom movement. Wholeheartedly means with complete sincerity and with keen interest. Joined the freedom movement after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre is the killing of a large number of people. I'm sure everybody is aware of Jallianwala case also. But means Nehru took more interest in politics after Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Now let's see what happened in Jallianwala Bagh massacre. On 13th April 1919, a large number of non-violent protesters, means no violence, no fight protesters, the one who object publicly, means they were not ready for something and they objected in publicly. On 13th April 1919, a large number of non-violent protesters gathered means came together at Jallianwala Bagh, when under the command of Brigadier General Dyer, the gates of the place were closed, so the protesters could not escape. I'm sure you must have gone to Amritsar and seen the Jallianwala Bagh. It is very big inside, but the outlet or the exit gate was very small from where it only one exit gate was there, and still there is only one exit gate there, and from there it was very difficult for a huge amount of people to move out. So large number of people gathered there to protest against those Britishers. So what happened there? General Dyer, he closed that gate, which was the only gate that time. At present, we have an entry gate and exit gate. Two gates are there. But that time, there was only one gate. And this General Dyer closed that gate. And all his military stood near the gate. And what did it do? He fired on those people. The unarmed people. When under the command of Brigadier General Dyer, the gates of the place were closed, so the protesters could not escape. Escape means to run away from that place. The protesters couldn't do that. Then the British military fired at them continuously for 10 minutes, killing 379 people and injuring at least 1,200 more people. When Nehru heard how cruelly, or how inhumanly those Britishers or the General Dyer has killed those unarmed people, these unarmed civilians were attacked. When Nehru came to know that, he vowed, means he promised to fight the British in every way he could, means he decided to fight against them and get freedom. This incident moved him to increase his efforts. Efforts means his involvement for India's independence. Nehru became a vital member of the Indian National Congress. Vital is full of energy, means full heartedly active member of the Indian National Congress, and was the president of this political party. Which part, president of which political party? Indian National Congress. He was deeply influenced by Mahatma Gandhi. Means he was influenced or affected by Mahatma Gandhi and his views and his way of getting independence, and worked very closely with him. He was even arrested several times for participating in the civil disobedience movement. Civil disobedience means a form of protest where people refuse to obey the government. Disobedience, obeying, not obeying the movement. But this time in jail only strengthened his resolve to gain independence for India. Resolve is hard work to find a solution. Means the more number of times he went to the jail or prison, his fight for freedom increased more. And he strengthened himself to fight against the Britishers. He also used this time to understand Gandhiji's principles of non-cooperation and non-violence. Now, while in the jail or while working with Mahatma Gandhi, Nehru understood or tried to understand Gandhiji's principles. What were Gandhiji's principles? Non-cooperation means not to cooperate with the government, and non-violence, and doing everything to fight against the Britishers, but without violence, without fighting. I'll continue explaining in my next video.